Hello, folks. This has gone Spy. The Spy will come to you live for the Ultimate Alliance. They're still in the same training simulation. After I'm dealing with Pile Driver and a couple of missions from last week of the training simulations. We're now moving on to the next training simulation. This one's going to be about Dragonman. If you guys don't know about Dragonman, you guys should check out the Act 2 of the... The Act 1 of the Ultimate Alliance. He was last seen in the Act 1 of the Ultimate Alliance when he was serving in Mandarin. So you better check him out. Guys,
Thor, Storm. Doctor Strange, Black Panther,
Marvel Royalty.
Royalty, huh? Still nothing, so... going on with this team until further notice. Alrighty, let's get things started.
Onward to battle!
This is also maybe the last versus villain of the training simulation I got currently, so... it's gonna be something
Dragonman is an android created by Professor Gregson Gifford. The professor was unable to animate it until a villain named Diablo appeared. He used supernatural powers to give the machine a spark of life.
Huh. Definitely something from the Frankenstein movie.
Though unable to talk, and slowly, Dragon Man is quite powerful. I would recommend avoiding his fire breath if you wish to complete this mission with your skin intact.
Copy that, Black Widow. My team, let's do this. Time to bring the hammer down. For Asgard.
Take
mind control spell. Damaged by the wind.
It was foolish of you to start this battle.
Move onward. Go off the edge. Fastest speed of light. Who's fastest lightning at this point?
this. You would dare.
These Galactics, Punishers, are not as, are no longer as they, as good as they are now. Alright, I think in this next door, yep, Evil Lizard, Dino Boy, dead ahead. Let's get him. Above the cards!
Be sure to wave your arms around. Of course. Your wish.
Hammer brains the hammer down the Dino Dragon Man.
Your scores were significantly higher than the last team's attempt at this scenario. And you had far fewer injuries as well.
Black Panther took most of the hits, but we were able to come out unscathed. Alrighty, so, that's pretty much it for the versus villains thing, so, alrighty, let's go with the Human Torch, the one of the members of the Fantastic Four. This is going to be interesting, seeing how he's going to be able to deal with things, so, let's see how, and this is going to be a backstory of the Human Torch. Let's get started.
It all started on the day that Reed Richards decided to test his rocket ship before the government could shut the project down. My sister Sue and I went along as crew, while Reed was co-pilot and Ben Grimm was the pilot. Once we left the atmosphere, our ship was hit by a freak radiation storm and it crashed back to Earth. That was when we discovered that the radiation had changed us, given us superpowers. I gained the ability to fly and to become covered in fire, the Human Torch. We decided to band together and use our powers for the good of mankind as the Fantastic Four. And life has been one wild ride ever since.
That's pretty much it for that Human Torch thing. Backstory thing and whatnot, but that's the best part of him, because he's always been on a worldwide.
For instance, worldwide. There was this one time where I went to the Skrull world alone and met up with an old friend.
Burn, baby, burn. Get creamed. If you can't play with fire, you're going to get burned. The Human Torch burn. That'll be a pun to it. Four members, Human Torch is the one that's been having most of the fun other than the Thing sometimes when they're together as partners, when they're trying not to kill each other. I'm truly going to enjoy the simulation. Have a nice flight to Human Torch Air Flight. you play with fire, you're going to get burned alive. Fire is life. Fire is wild. Fire is dangerous unless someone knows how to control it. Time to light things up over on the cooking on Turkey's Thanksgiving. Every turn that Johnny Storm takes as the Human Torch is an adventure of wildlife stream. Take the heat, you might as well stay out of the field of fire. Doc?
Johnny Storm, I don't know if you're incredibly brave or just plain stupid to come here without the rest of the Fantastic Four.
Oh, well, since we knew you were here, Piebot, it was decided only one of us had to come. And I drew the short straw, so here I am.
You are an impetuous boy, and today I am going to teach you why I am known as the Power Scroll. You are no match for my biogenetically engineered powers.
One that's been forced upon you, or you just happen to be a volunteer. Either way, don't matter.
I love to hear you ramble on with your little speeches. It makes smacking you down just that much more fun.
Indeed.
No one talks to the power scroll like that! I will destroy you!
We'll bring on Pydonk. Face of Pydonk, you're just not going to be able to beat because Johnny Storm, the Human Torch, is just a little bit too hot for you, for your icy powers. Just because you're bioengineering doesn't mean that for a fact that you might actually be able to handle Johnny Storm, the Human Torch, the wildlife member of the Fantastic Four. You're done. Lights out for you, Pie Dog.
Good old Pie Bok. But that should come as no surprise. I'm Johnny Storm, the Human Torch. And I'm also a member of the greatest team this world's ever known, the Fantastic Four.
Indeed. Well, second greatest team the world has ever known, but yeah, you get the point. Alrighty. And that's it for this train simulation, folks. This has gone Spy, the Spy, sign off till after these messages.